Once your 3D lines are set up, you can use the line list tool from the P&ID to add inline valves and components. This process is similar to how the lines were initially created. To begin, open the relevant model file. For reference, the existing lines from the previous work will be visible. Close any unnecessary panels, such as orphaned fasteners, and access the P&ID line list to view the line details. The next step is to add the required valves to the designated lines. Start by opening the P&ID to review the correct order of components. For instance, if you observe a blue line labeled 222, you'll see it contains a check valve, gate valve, and globe valve. In Plant 3D 2025, the order of components in the P&ID will match what appears in the 3D model. Let's move on to placing valves on line 1000. For this line, a 2-inch gate valve is needed on the smaller section, followed by a 6-inch gate valve and check valve on the larger section. Locate line 1000, highlight the gate valve, right-click and select Place Item. Drag and drop it into position within the model. Repeat the process for the check valve and any additional components as required. Similarly, on the 2-inch line segment, place the corresponding 2-inch valve. As you position these components, note that their tags, example, HA109, HA110, and HA114, are automatically included. If you notice any question marks on these tags, don't be concerned. This occurs due to the model being concatenated within the database. The data will be resolved and finalized later, ensuring there are no duplicates in the completed model. Now, let's look at line 222. This line requires placement of a gate valve, check valve, and globe valve. Verify the tag numbers as you work, ensuring they align correctly. For example, you may see tags such as 108, 107, and 106. Place these valves in sequence on their respective line segments. Finally, add components to the 8-inch line. This may include a gate valve, check valve, and ball valve. By transferring the pre-specified information from the P&ID into the 3D model, you eliminate the need for manual typing and ensure consistency. Once the components are placed, delete any duplicates or temporary tags to maintain a clean dataset. With the valves and components now accurately positioned, you're ready to move forward to the final step, where the model will undergo validation.